Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Visit Joan, and we are back for another house tour in Strange Town with a house from Veronaville, actually. But I decided to choose this house because it had every single bedroom that I needed. And as to who lives here, this is where Chloe and Lola Curious live. And as for what they have been up to, Lola married a man named Mitchell Preston, or Parson, I think it was. I don't know, I'm gonna have to look that up. But, anyway, and they had two boys, and I thought that it was only fair that they would have two boys because Pascal has a girl, Vinkud has a girl, Laszlo has both, Jenny has both, so, you know, I thought it would only be fair if they had two boys. But anyway, her twin sister, Chloe, also lives here, and Chloe has a daughter named Emily, and actually she was kind of like the product of a one-night stand because Chloe is a romance sim, and I figured, you know, she probably wouldn't have any contact with the guy, so she's really just a single mother, and she's living with her sister and her sister's family. But anyway, this is the little entryway to the house over here. We have a weird plant thing. Why are some of these plants purple? Like, that makes no sense. But anyway, we're going to go into the entryway, and the first thing we see is a giant foosball table. I mean, I'd love to have that in my house, man. Like, well, not really, because I've had nobody to play with, but... And that's simply because I'm an only child, so, you know, I don't have really any companions except my guinea pigs. But, anyway, is there a photo behind that basketball? Oh, yep, there is. Anyway, there's where the kids' backpacks are. There's, a little, like, bulletin board. And now we're gonna go into the living room. This is kind of like a living room, kids' room area. There's Emily on the computer. We've got music. We've got the cat area. We've got a lot of kids' stuff over here. But, this is the living area. We got Lola watching the cooking channel. I don't know why the cooking channel, but we have, I decided to go with blue and, like, orange. I don't know why, because I don't even like that color combination. Long story. But now they're all playing a game of Party Frenzy. We can see, like, over here, they got, oh, there they go. They're going off to work, I think. Chloe's still gaming on. Oh, nope, they're still here. They're, apparently, they decided they wanted to talk to each other a little bit. I think it was a little too early to go to work because, you know, when I came in this house, it was actually at night, and I'm like, you know what? I kind of want to burn some time here. So I had to take the cat to bed. So anyway, here we are. We are outside. We got a beehive swings, those little pinwheels that hypnotize you. And we have a bar area and a nice little table, some nice flowers and a grill. And we're going to look at the bar area a little bit more in detail here. Here we have a hot tub and basketball hoop and a balcony. Yeah, that's a balcony. But anyway, we're going to go back through the entryway area and we're going to look at some other rooms on the other side. But what was I even talking about before this? I don't even remember. But we have the dining room right here. We'll look at that in a minute. Here is the bathroom on the first floor. It's a pretty big bathroom, actually. I have enough room to put, like, everything. There's, like, little curtains there. There's a giant mirror, which is... Oh, Emily's in here. That's great, really. We got walked in on the bathroom by a sim. That is wonderful. And we got the cat also walking in on us. That cat is... Yeah, that is great. Anyway, we're going to leave the bathroom now. We're going to check out the dining room. It's mostly, I'm not a big fan of neutral colors, but this turned out pretty well in my opinion. I mean, we got the pop of color with the blue curtains, and we have a blue kitchen, which we will see in a minute. But, we have a little, ooh, pink china. That's pretty cool. Like, don't know why you'd have that in a house full of guys, but... Well, I mean, there's three girls, three guys, and the cat's a guy, I think. I don't know. I think it is. Oh, yeah, because when they took him to the vet, they said, oh, do you want to get him neutered? And I'm like, no. So the cat is a boy. But here we are in the extremely blue kitchen. It's really kind of small compared to the rest of the house, once you think about it. We got the cat food bowl here. We got some counters. We got a smoke detector. We don't have a stove hood for some reason. I don't even know. What do stove hoods even do? I have no idea. Ours is just the light, but at least I think it is. We got all kinds of appliances here. It's just a pretty, you know, straightforward kitchen. I've done better jobs at creating kitchens over time because this is probably back in the early days. Probably I did this around, like, June or May. I don't exactly remember. But, anyway, we are going to take one final look at the kitchen, and then we are going to go downstairs into the basement. And there are basically, like, two bedrooms down in the basement, along with a litter box And a punching bag. Actually, we're gonna take a look down in the landing first. We got a dartboard over here. That's great. Void cutter machine. We got some fish. I don't know why I'm saying in all of this stuff because, you know, I mean, you can see it, but we're gonna go in this door right over here. And this is the downstairs bathroom. It's a pretty neutral grayish bathroom. I call that grayish blue, maybe? No, that's gray. That's definitely gray. But we got some blue tiles and we got some blue rugs. And we got a shower and we got a sink. And again, bathroom, that's kind of obvious. But anyway, in here we have a laundry room. And oh my goodness, this room is so small. I could not get a good camera angle at all where it didn't look completely distorted. But I think I did all right. We got the smart hub and the, ironing board and just a bunch of stuff in there, like, you know. So anyway, over here we have the bedroom of the oldest boy. I do not remember his name at the moment, but I gotta get this done. So he has some posters. I think he's kind of like, he's really just like a loner, and that's why he has, you know, his room in the basement, because it's like, it's solitude. It's nobody's gonna bother him down here, and it's kind of like his own little personal area where he can just like chill out and just be himself. But we have one more bedroom down here, and that is, oh, look, there's the cat bed. Okay, so I guess we got two more bedrooms. But anyway, we got Chloe's bedroom over here. And this is probably one of my favorite rooms in the house, because I just love how it turned out. I love the teal blue, light blue with the pink and the, I just went kind of a little experimental in this room. We got some sofas because it was a pretty big room and I didn't know what else to do with it, you know? I've been getting better at like cluttering these builds, watching people build and recreating, you know, rooms in the, not rooms, but like houses from The Sims 2 really helped me with building. I'm building much better houses now. But anyway, we're gonna head upstairs to the second floor. And here we have some more bedrooms. Here's the landing. We have the Roomba, which the little cat can ride, which is really the only reason I put it there. But I just think that's adorable. But we go in this room. This is Emily's room. It's a pretty, you know, girl's room. I decided to do this girl's room in light blue because why not? But we have this mirror thing from like kids' room stuff that I almost never use because I kind of find it a little ugly and, well, not ugly, just a little weird looking, I guess. I really don't know, but she has a nice room. She has, you know, posters on the walls, a little whatever that is, dresser thing, I don't even know. And then this room is the younger boy's room, and he's got penguin walls and a little bed over here. And you know, he has his own desk. He loves Void Critters, apparently. And that one, Void Critter, is ugly. I think that's like a parody of Castform, but it just looks like, no. Anyway, we're gonna go across the no, we're not. I forgot I edited that part out. Anyway, we're here in this bathroom. This is a blue bathroom. This is kind of like the boys' bathroom, so that's kind of why I feel like it was before Chloe moved in. So that's why there's a baseball, which, well, not that girls can't like baseball. Girls can like baseball too. We don't do gender stereotypes here. Anyway, this is the last room. This is the master bedroom. This is, oh my goodness, this bedroom is so beautiful. I love it. We got the beautiful butterflies paintings. I love that painting. I love the little, I love the blues. I love the little, what am I even going to call that? Like the room divider there. But anyway, we got a fancy, colorful bench. We got two doors. That door leads out to the little balcony that we just saw. And over here we have kind of like the dressing area, and that's why it's kind of like a little bit walled off so they could have a little bit of privacy. Or like, you know, if you have the kids sleeping in the bed, they can have privacy while they get dressed. And out here is the balcony. Oh, look, there's Kaylin Langrack. Well, what is she doing all the way in Strange Town? I have absolutely no idea. But anyway, we're gonna head back because we have to check out the master bathroom. And that is right here. And you can see it's another blue bathroom. I really have a thing for blue bathrooms in this house. But anyway, you guys, that is the house. If you enjoyed this video, if you like this house, please leave a comment, leave a like, because consider subscribing, and I'm going to be seeing you next time, everybody. So, bye!